take a mortal man. You put him in control. Watch him become a dog. Blah, 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 blah.
Yes! Well done! Dude, we've been practicing together for this intro. How about that?
Yeah, for 10 minutes!
For 10 minutes! We practiced the whole full 10 minutes right there. Yeah, we just figured we'd do something together this time, and that means that a lot of more people will fall in love with Luis, which is great! Welcome to Metal Morning number 13. This is my wife, Louise. I'm Ola England. And what do we have today on the plate? It's a Sunday morning.
Yep.
Are we getting, like, is it Christmas time already? Are we starting to...
Soon December, at least. It's 1 month to go.
You know, I've seen a lot of people. You already hear the songs and all that shit in the stores.
Yeah.
And people are already putting up their Christmas lights and whatever. And it's... I mean, in Sweden, it's incredibly dark during the winter. So I understand why people like to put up their lights. It's
very
illuminating
dark
the darkness a little bit. So I think it's important for us Swedes not to get overly depressed. So we put our lights up a little earlier. Good Christmas gift suggestion. Just saying, chug life.
Yeah, it's a good one.
It's a good one. Another tip for a good Christmas gift. Bundle.
Yeah.
Ola England signed Feared and Face Dumble. Dumble.
Bundle.
We still have that going on. It's just that it's 7-inch and a CD signed. Done.
Yep.
On the website. And also, yesterday and today, we're also running another special on the Solar Guitars website. You know why?
No. Nope.
Because it's the 4th anniversary of Solar Guitars.
Ooh.
That was yesterday. We're running a special on our outlet store. You know, the outlet store where we sell guitars a little less expensive. There's an additional 15% off!
Oh my god.
But it ends tonight. So you have to be quick if you want to get one for a good price. I mean, it's getting an outlet store guitar is the perfect way of getting a well-specced out guitar for a really, really good price. So, yes! Now that everyone has left because they've been listening to me rambling and, you know, I'm becoming the salesperson Ola. And I know a lot of people are maybe don't like that. But that's how we survive, okay? That's how we survive. Thank you so much for the support, everyone. We do love you guys. The news?
Yes.
You know what I wish for this Christmas?
No.
A longer cable for my solution right here. People have been complaining. Why are people... I don't know why people... Oh, people always like to complain. I think that's the problem.
It's like, you should have this and this cable, blah, blah, blah.
Oh, you should have at least 5 meter cable. Well, I'm sorry. This is 1.5. We have a great piece of news. Whitesnake has announced a new bass player. And it's not any bass player. It's Tanya O'Callaghan. Why is this so cool? Because we met Tanya...
And you played with her.
And I played with her on the Dime Bash. And she was an amazing person. I mean, the little that we got to talk to her, she seemed like a really high-spirited lady and a lot of energy. And she was so f***ing awesome on stage. Congratulations to her. That's great news. All the best. Holy
Mostly
shit.
Congratulations to Whitesnake.
Exactly. You said it right. Next piece of news is that the Grammy Awards of 2022 is up, and there's a cut. We're gonna check out the metal contributions. We have Deftones, Genesis, Dream Theater, hello, and Gojira, Amazonia, Mastodon, Pushing the Tides, the album that I'm reviewing, and Rob Zombie. So I thought it was cool that Dream Theater was nominated for a Grammy.
That's cool.
I mean, I think it's time for them to get recognized as a major act in metal.
Because they've not received a Grammy before?
I don't think they maybe they've been nominated, but I don't think they've won a Grammy. But I definitely think they're up there. I think it's time to recognize them as the big act that they are.
Yeah.
Even though they're prog metal and, you know, all the nerds listen to prog metal. But, you know.
Aren't nerds important?
Yes! Exactly! That's what I said. But I think that Gojira or Mastodon are probably going to win. Just saying. Just my slight little educated guess. Then we have some very important news. You know, the baby on Nirvana's Nevermind put a lawsuit against Nirvana for destroying
that.
His life, basically. You know, everyone has seen his penis, which which I guess is his problem.
That's devastating, child
abuse or something like that. Anyways, he made a comment. But the thing is that this guy, he earlier has been like very proud about him being the baby, and he made like new photographs of him in the pool. In the same way, and you know, and he's basically talking to people about being the cool, you know, baby in the Nevermind cover.
5 seconds of
exactly, but then he probably found out that, and he got sad that everyone made a lot of money, and his parents made like $200 or something. To quote him, "It's a trip. Everyone involved in the album has tons and tons of money. I feel like I'm the last little bit of grunge rock. I'm living in my mom's house and driving a Honda Civic." I mean, what's wrong with Honda Civic now? I don't understand. "It's hard to not get upset when you hear how much money was involved. I go to a baseball game and think about it. Man, everybody at this baseball game has probably seen my little baby penis." Which is probably true. It's a legit point. Well, the news is that he amends the lawsuit against the band. And reading it right now, maybe he wanted a little bit more fame. So he said he would put up the lawsuit and then get rid of it, maybe to, you know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I guess it's a lot of work to, you know.
It's very expensive to
like
get
that
into
together.
Yes, it's very expensive to just put lawyers in, at least in the United States of America. It's very expensive, so I think it was more of a PR stunt, probably. Yeah. Then we can talk, because since I'm a drummer now, since like a month or so, something I found interesting was that there's been a poll, basically the 10 best male drummers in the world right now, as decided by you, okay?
Who's on there?
And who's on there? Well, the winner is Marty Duplantier of Gojira, which I think is definitely well-deserved. He's one of the new, groovier... I wouldn't say new, but maybe like the closest you get to someone at the same status as Vinnie Paul of Pantera, but in the metal world today.
Yeah.
He's incredibly awesome. I completely agree about that. Alex Bent, Trivium? Yeah, sure. I watched his live stream. Can't say I've been listening too much. You listened to the new Trivium album. How was the drums?
I mean, I wasn't listening specifically.
I gotcha. Okay. Third on the list, Lars Ulrich of Metallica. Which I know a lot of people are probably going to be like, maybe
I guess
not.
He just needed to be on there.
He just probably just needed to be on there. Exactly. You're completely right. And I think, even though a lot of people think that he's a shit drummer, there's no denying in how important he has been for a lot
of
drummers. And he's been an influence for a lot of upcoming male drummers. So you can't really take that away from him. He's incredibly important.
I mean, this list is of the 10 best drummers.
Male drummers.
Metal drummers, not the 10 best technical
exactly.
I mean, it was
best metal drummers.
So I mean
these guys, they're extremely technical.
Yeah.
And Lars is not really technical. Then we have Mastodon, Brand Daler, who also sings, obviously, when he's playing drums. So that's an incredible feat right there. Spirit Box. Mike Mangini. Mike Mangini. And I must say, on the new album, I didn't say that when we did the review, but I wanted to say that it's the first time I actually thought the drums were really good on the album, when Mike Mangini has been a part of the band. Because before it was a little stale, coming from Mike Portnoy going to Mike Mangini. I mean, he was doing his job great, but this is the first time I feel like, shit, these drums are really cool.
Maybe it's
himself, and before it was, being controlled by others in the band. I don't know, maybe he got more...
in his shoes.
Yes, exactly. Maybe he got to make his own take on this stuff. Nico McBrain, Iron Maiden. I mean, still going strong. That's an old band too. Eloy Casagrande. This is probably one of my favorite drummers right now. He's such a powerhouse of a drummer. Check this out. I mean, he hits incredibly hard.
Yeah.
And then we have Bullet for My Valentine. John Otto, Limp Bizkit. How was the drums on the new album?
We'll talk about that later.
Okay, great. That was the news, everyone. Thank you. All right. Ola and Luis tasting shit. Hello, can you... So, long time no tasting. What's this?
We got something.
Let's just read the letter. Hey, Luis and Ola. It was nice to meet you at the show in Köge. Oh. Oh, shit. It's a guy. You handled the lead superb. It was the gig where I was the lone guitar player of the band when Jensen didn't arrive to the show. Even my girlfriend, who is not a metalhead, enjoyed the show. Her and I watched your metal morning videos together. Here are some different delicacies from Bornholm, even one from my hometown, Nexø. I hope you both enjoy them. Og, kan vi få mer Pix content?
Okay.
She wants more Pix content.
Du, jag glömde min vigselring.
She forgot the wedding rings, just saying. All right, that has been settled. Now everyone's going to question why I'm not wearing a wedding ring.
Sorry.
And that's just because I play guitar a lot and drums and whatnot. But I promise you, it's at home by the nightstand. I know exactly where it is. It's not gone or anything. It's settled. But people are going to hate us anyways.
Yep.
So we got these things. What are these things? Okay, so this is basically a ball of mustard right there. From Bornholm, which is an island south of Sweden. But it belongs to Denmark, I think. Or it's like an in-between.
I guess it's closer to Sweden, isn't it?
It's closer to Sweden, but it belongs to Denmark. What? Wait. What?
She doesn't like the
She doesn't like the intern. Well, that's good. Go get him. Go get him, Pix. Uh-huh. And then we have this, which we are very familiar of, because this is one of Luis's favorites right there.
Yep.
Then we got some Caramel Company at Caramel Bar, and a Fleur de and Salt Caramel Bar. So bars with different tastes.
Fleur de milk?
Fleur is with cream, I think.
Cream, okay.
And then we have Rug Chips. Did she just fart and yell at the same time? Because it smells like fart.
Yeah, it's gonna taste great now.
All right, let's just start with this. Do you have mustard on all of this? Is that the point of the mustard? Rug Chips, they don't look... Oh, it's basically like small dried bread.
Maybe that's what you're supposed to have the mustard on.
You know, I'm not a mustard guy, but let's just do it. How do you even open?
That's very hard.
How do you open a mustard bottle even?
Men varför tar du loss den där för?
What?
It's supposed to be stick there so you don't lose it. And you have to have a knife to cut the top off.
How should I know?
It's really nice though.
Ugh. Okay, I'm gonna take this. Take this. I'm not a fan of mustard, but I'm taking one for my Danish friend.
It's gonna go on coming, so we need to have some paper. It was actually good.
Just put this thing on. Was it?
I think so. You didn't like it?
No, but I don't like mustard. So I took one for the team. I tried
these
it.
These were good. You need to try one of those.
Just because I hate licorice?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do it. But no, you know, I want to try these first because I don't want to damage my taste.
Should we take one?
Okay. Take one each.
One each.
Oh, look at that. That looks great. Look.
Ooh, that looks nice.
That looks really good, actually.
Fleur de and salt. Mm. That's really nice.
That was good. I don't think it's healthy.
A lot of sugar?
It's just very, very chewy. That's a full meal right there. Okay, last but not least, we have the licorice, and this is chocolate-coated licorice. So, I mean, it's half and half, something I hate and something I love, you know? So it has chocolate, and then is it salt licorice or is it just sweet?
I would guess it's salt.
That's the favorite
but
one
I
hate.
But you can read, maybe?
No, I don't want to read, I just want to get rid of it. I mean, the chocolate is good.
I just love them.
No.
Need a drink?
Yes. Drink a bottle of mustard, maybe, after this. No, but that's the thing with licorice. Either you hate it or you love it.
Yeah.
And we're the complete opposites there, for sure. Keep this one for yourself. I'll take these. And you can keep the mustard too, there you go. Great, thank you. All right, that was Ola and Louise tasting shit. Thank you so much, Simone and Sander.
Thank you.
For that. That was amazing. Thank you so much. Album review of the week, holy shit. Okay, so you've been reviewing the new Limp Bizkit album.
Yeah.
Still Sucks is the name of this album. Let me know your thoughts about Limp Bizkit. It's a very short album.
It's very short. The thing is about this album is that the first song really kick ass. It's
out of style.
Yeah, it's what you wanted from this album. Mm-hmm. But I really wanted more of those songs.
Yeah.
Because there's only that one. Mm-hmm. The other ones are, I don't know. Some of them are just talking or very mellow songs in the middle. So there's like four real songs and then there's just a pause in the middle and then the I don't know, it's very inconsistent.
So you feel like there's a lot of filler and maybe they didn't have they had a couple of songs and then they just filled that out and made an album at 30 minutes.
Yeah.
That might be true.
I would be good with only that first song. And then there's the last song, Goodbye or something, that I just been stuck on my mind.
Okay, why?
Because it's very catchy.
Oh, okay.
It's like a fun, catchy song. Like.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. I heard this.
Yeah, you heard this on the radio.
Yeah.
I put it on.
Yeah.
That's actually the song that I like, but.
Yeah. I have.
Easy.
Just to give my perspective on this, I haven't listened that much to. I don't haven't listened through the album. I listened to the singles that you talked about. Out of Style is a great song. And that's basically. That could have been lifted out from like Significant Other, which I think is a great album.
Okay.
Full of songs like that, like hits, basically. And the other one's a little so-so, maybe. So just like you said, maybe they had like material for an EP and then just fill it out for a, to make it a full album.
I mean, I would love to hear more of that style of the first song. That would be great.
Yeah.
I mean, they would make the album even shorter, like five songs.
Yeah,
if they were like that, that
make it an EP instead.
Yeah.
Okay. What would you? How would you rate the album?
3 out of 10.
Ooh, that's tough.
I know. Yeah.
That's hard.
Sorry.
My wife is not playing around.
This is not my favorite band.
No, no.
From the beginning, so.
It would probably have gotten a better review score by me. That was Limp Bizkit, Still Sucks, review by Luis. Harsh, man, harsh. I like it. And since I'm the worst with names, I'm going to bring out the list of songs from the new Mastodon album, Hushed and Grim, that I've been listening to. And this is not a short album. This is 1 hour 25 seconds long. But it's been an absolute bliss to listen to this album. It's a lot of fun. I'm going to be completely honest. I didn't pay any attention to Mastodon. Like the first albums, I haven't listened to them at all. But the hits. Basically. But I did listen to the previous album, Emperor of Sands, and I truly enjoyed that album. That was a great album. This Hushed and Grim sounds a lot more mature, I would say. Even though the Emperor of Sands was also mature, but this seems a little darker, a little bit proggier, and definitely heavier in a sense. The only thing is that I think the album could have definitely been shorter in this case.
Yeah.
Complete opposite from Limp Bizkit, Still Sucks. I wouldn't mind coming in as a new fan to have to come out wanting more, if you understand. And this leaves a little. This is just a little too much in length. But with that said, the songs are absolutely amazing. They're really captivating. What I think keeps it interesting is hearing how everyone switches out their vocals, because there are three of them that are singing. You know, there's new parts. And the one guitar player sings, then the drummer sings, and it's just like every singer has their own voice. And you hear immediately who's who.
Yeah.
So it's not like it's like, oh, just a chorus here and there. And you hear when it's Brent, like, whiskey. And it's just really cool. And it keeps up my attention span when I'm listening through the album. Yeah,
is there one song that you really...
You know, it's really hard for me to say a favorite song because I listened to this album without looking at, you know, which song it was. It's a flow of music, and that's how I like it to be. So I can't really say which one it was that I liked the most, but it's a trip for sure to listen to this album. I would give this album an 8 out of 10. It's probably one of the albums I'm the most excited about. No, you know what? 9 out of 10. I'm changing my mind here. It's, you know, I enjoyed it. This is probably one of the albums I've enjoyed the most in a long time, I would say.
Cool.
It's not a 10. And no, let's go back. It's an 8 out of 10. Because it's still a little too long. Okay? 8 out of 10. But that's a great score, 8 out of 10.
Yeah.
So that's Hushed and Grim by Mastodon. And I was thinking for this time, instead of us coming up with albums to review, let's give that option to the viewers of Metal Morning.
These guys.
So you guys get to decide which album that we get to review in the next Metal Morning. How about that? I think that's
Could
a good deal.
Could you help us?
That's a good deal. In the comment section, write your suggestions.
In the comment section.
In
section. Sorry.
Comment section.
In the comment section.
Maybe I'll pull a...
Do not mail me suggestions.
Do not mail any of us suggestions, please. Just put them in the comment section.
Yes.
Comment section. Not nowhere else, okay? Thank you so much. That was album reviews. Great. Okay. Question of the day. From Bigus86, A up, one for the FAQ. Do your children share the same interest as you do, or do they just chin you off and want to do something totally different? Keep up the good work and keep with the Ola tasting shit. My other half watches you and Louise too, and this is her highlight.
Nice.
Nice.
Should we start with the son?
yes, sure.
He actually got a guitar. When was this? Maybe when he was 8 or 9?
Yeah, exactly. Just to have it there.
He has an acoustic guitar, a small one.
If there's a possibility of him picking up, it's there. That's what I want.
It's
there. I don't want to push. I don't want to push.
Unplayed.
But if they show any type of interest, then, you know, like that.
Yeah.
There's a guitar there.
Yeah.
But he doesn't care.
I don't mean, I think he doesn't have the, what heter det?
Musicality?
No, tålamode.
The patience
of learning something just yet.
Yeah.
So maybe later.
I mean, I found guitar when I was 13.
Yeah.
And he's
not 13.
He's not 13. So,
not yet.
You know, I'm just saying we might be a little similar. Maybe he will find an interest for that when he becomes a teenager.
Better.
And I'm going to be there.
Yeah.
With like 5,000 solo guitars and an app.
This app. He really likes to play video games.
Yeah, that's
you
his thing.
That.
I mean, obviously his thing right now, just video games. And a little bit of movies, I guess.
So the daughter. Mm-hmm. She actually shares my interest of horses.
But that's because you forced her to a little
bit.
Yeah, that was,
no,
yes,
I didn't.
Yes. No. I see.
But that's
big.
The same, you know, the small little piece of interest.
Yeah.
Oh, sure, yes, let's go to the
but,
stable.
But you do it like this, you just push her in.
No,
so
I don't.
She
I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I don't want to scare her off, but she likes horses and she likes riding, so she's been going there.
And I say on the free time, I mean, my hobbies are what I'm doing here.
Yeah.
At the office. And at home, I'm basically just doing home stuff. You know, watching TV and play video games. And now I'm starting doing paradiddles and shit while I'm watching movies. So I'm constantly practicing drums at home. So I don't really have any interest at home. They were like, oh, let's go and, you know, cut down a tree or something and bring my son. I don't have that hobby.
When they're still kind of small.
Yeah, they're too small.
They're still like,
we go
finding
out, for walks
out
with
who
the
they
dog.
Are.
That's what, like, something we do together.
Yeah.
We take walks with the dog.
Yeah.
Great, thank you. Good question. And that, my friends, was the end of Metal Morning 13. Thank you so much for watching, guys. And we'll see you
in
two weeks.
What should we play?
What should we play? Suggest what we should play for next time too.
Something that is not too
technical
on the bass.
Yes, exactly.
Please.
Goodbye.